Welcome back. I'm Dwayne Wonders, and this is a space where we spark a discussion about fascinating topics. We're going to keep it interesting. We're definitely going to keep it entertaining. Stay tuned. Hey guys, my name is Dwayne Wonders. Yes, that's Dwayne Wonders, as in W-O-N-D-R-O-U-S. Yes, I changed my name because of branding purposes. Today's topic is going to be Little Mermaid. Halle Bailey is a new Little Mermaid, and she is, oh my God, a very good pick for the Little Mermaid. She could sing, she looks like Ariel, she has the presence of a Disney princess. I mean, come on, what more could you ask for? But of course, there are people out there that are going to say, oh, she can't be the Little Mermaid because she's black. And listen, I understand. I am from that generation of when Ariel first took the stage. I'm from that generation, you know? I remember when I was in Jamaica. Yes, Jamaica, because I'm Jamaican, okay? So I remember when I was in Jamaica and I first saw Ariel. I fall in love with the character. I fall in love with who she is and what she represents. Someone that wanted to, you know, have a better life. Someone that wanted to, you know, see what's on the other side. That was kind of like me with America. You know, I was in Jamaica. I always wanted to come to America and see what was what. And now that I'm here, I mean, different story, same, okay? Different story, same, all right? But for the most part, I'm happy to be here. There are some things that I'm not like happy about when it comes to like, you know, being a black man in America. But for all intents and purposes, let's just stick to Little Mermaid. That could be a different video. Now, when it came to picking the character of the Little Mermaid, there were some names floating around. There were Ariana Grande and Zendaya. Now, Ariana Grande, I could definitely see that she has a powerful voice. You know, we could just dot it here, right? You know, we got ourselves a little white mermaid. Zendaya is an interesting topic to me because she is biracial. She has a black parent and a white parent, okay? But still, we were campaigning for her to be Ariel. Now, what's the difference between Zendaya and Halle Bailey is that it comes down to, like, race and phenotype. So Zendaya, even though she's a biracial woman, she could pass as a white woman, okay? If you dye her hair, she could definitely pass as a white woman or like some ambiguous chick versus, you know, Halle Bailey. She can't pass as anything else but black. She has very African phenotype, and that's okay. For a long time with colonization, we've been told that, you know, having African features is a bad thing. Having African features means that you're ugly. But hey, times are changing, and I'm so glad that Disney got with the groove. I just have a question. Where are they filming The Little Mermaid? Because if it's in the Caribbean, it definitely makes sense. It totally makes sense. Why would you have a pale-skinned, red-haired girl star in the Caribbean? Okay, when you think about the Caribbean is very diverse in different ethnicities. But when you think about the Caribbean, it's people that look like me, okay? You do have some mulattoes from Puerto Rico, from, you know, Dominican Republic, you know. You do have, you know, some variations of, like, you know, in Trinidad you have like Indians, but for the majority of the part, it's black people that were brought over from Africa during colonization of those countries, okay? So majority of the population in the Caribbean is black. Sebastian is also Jamaican, okay, by the accent, from my culture, okay? It only makes sense to have, if you're gonna remake this and be respectable of the people that's living there right now, because I'm like, how in the hell back in the day did they get away with, you know, placing this white girl in the Caribbean Ocean, okay? No disrespect to Ariel, I love Little Mermaid. It's one of my favorite cartoon, okay? Favorite cartoon. Cartoon animation, I have no idea. Like, comment down in the comment section, let me know what it is, okay? Because I don't know, all right? So it's from the Caribbean island, okay? So if you're gonna make a remake, it only makes sense to pick someone that's black. I'm just saying, it makes sense. As far as I'm concerned, this is a correction. This is a correction from the original, because come on guys, a pale red-haired girl in the Caribbean with no suntan, just going about our business, not getting burnt. I mean, come on, man. Come on. Now, if you don't like what is going on, don't watch it. Do not watch it. It's fine. go ahead, don't spend your money, get out the movie theaters, go home, be mad, do what you, whatever you want to do. I remember I was watching this show called Legends of Tomorrow, and I remember they were doing like Vixen's story, and I was so excited to see Vixen on the screen. I was like, yes, Vixen, 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 Vixen. But anyway, I digress. Vixen, her storyline got messed up. She got played by a biracial woman. Okay, we let that pass because most of our superheroes as black people are played by biracial people. And that's fine. You know what I mean? But it also kind of, you know, show how colonization works. The more close you are to white, you're right. The more close you are to black, you're wrong. Now, in the Vixen storyline, Anansi, an African god, he imbued four totems, four, and he split it across the sub-Saharan continent. And so when I was watching Legends of Tomorrow, I saw a white lady, and they say that her background is Middle Eastern, so she's entitled to the totem. She's with the Wind Totem. Not only that, Vixen Totem, that is supposedly specific to her bloodline, could be worn by anyone. So Vixen Totem end up with a white lady. The Wind Totem end up with a white lady that happens to be Middle Eastern. That left me like, what? And you know what? I stopped watching Legends of Tomorrow. So if you don't like something, don't watch it. But what you will not do is bash this girl, okay? This is her big break. You know what? I have a problem with Americans and treating, you know, black kids as adults, okay? You need to stop it, okay? Stop it. I remember, you know, being in Jamaica and I was a kid, but when I came to America, I was an adult. Now, the white kids got to be kids. The Hispanic light-skinned kids got to be kids. The Asian kids got to be kids. But when it came to black kids, you guys treat them like adults. That needs to stop. All this bullying that you're doing on social media, cut it out, okay? What the is wrong with you, okay? You need to think about yourself. Think about your child. Would you want someone to bully your child, your niece, your nephew, you know, someone just calling out names, saying very dirty things to your child? Come on, stop it. Cut it the hell out. And stand is black people using their platform to basically just on this little girl. Okay? Now, black people in America, we have, because I'm in America, so black people in America have the stereotype that they don't support each other, that they don't like each other. And I just hate to see videos online of black people say, oh, we don't want you as a Little Mermaid. Then don't see her. Why are you using your platform to defame a little girl? Have some common sense. Have some, you know, decorum about yourself. Shut the up. Change takes time, okay? I know that, change takes time. When Jason Momoa tried to play Aquaman, there was a lot of backlash. I don't understand. He wasn't white, but guess what? We survived, didn't we? We survived, didn't we? He did an amazing job, and that's one of my favorite DC movies. Now, fun fact, let me give you some fun fact. Aladdin was not Middle Eastern originally. He was Chinese, okay? Chinese. And look at that beautiful movie that we have, Ariel. She was not supposed to be a redhead, but in the realms of cartoon, they changed her hair red because they figured it looked better in animation, cartoon. I still don't know. Comment down below. Let me know what is it. So they changed her hair red, you know, just so it looks better in the cartoon or animation. Now, yes, Halle Bailey doesn't have the phenotype of the original. Well, she's not the original, but of the Disney version, Little Mermaid. Okay, she is not a pale-skinned girl with a red head. But for me, and I'm talking for myself, when I thought about Ariel, when I think about Ariel to me, you know, the essence of Ariel is her voice. It's the fact that she is this little mermaid. She is this little mermaid with this nice angelic voice. And Halle Bailey embodies that. I mean, come on now. Come on. Now, stay tuned for a clip of like Halle Bailey singing.
Unforgettable. That's what you are. Unforgettable. Though near or far, you're like a song of love that clings to me. How the thought of you does things to me. Wish that I am unforgettable too.
She even looks like the Little Mermaid. Oh my God, what a voice. Look at this picture. I'm gonna show you the thumbnail again, like, so you can look at it in like full detail. Just look at the picture. She looks like the Little Mermaid. Look at it, check it out. In honor of the Little Mermaid, you know, I got my little hat. I got my little shirt. You know what I mean? I got these like nice, you know, color contact lenses, eyes, you know what I mean? Just to like, you know, get that ocean vibe. Anyway, you know, to me, she could be a Little Mermaid, okay? She is our Little Mermaid for this generation. So, now that this is over, comment down in the comment section, do you think that she is our Little Mermaid, or is she not my Little Mermaid like everybody else is saying? I'll see you next time. Take care, everyone. Oh, and don't forget to like, subscribe, hit the notification bell, and share this content if you care. Come on, let's grow this channel together. I mean, come on now. Who could be this fly? I mean, nobody but me. Now, you know what I mean? Who could be this fly? Like, come on now. Let's grow this channel together, all right? Until then, my name is Dwayne Wonders. Have a good day.